It. Yo, what's up, everybody? This is BO5 and Zaz 104, keeping the beat with Monster Prom. Nearing close to the prom right now, so it's gonna be pretty good. It is my turn.
A 2-minute video.
And after he cock blocked me royally, I am going to switch seats with Devin and take the seat.
Man, I'm gonna go cry myself to sleep now, man.
Well, it's fine because you're not really taking anybody to the prom, are you?
I'm taking myself.
It's cool.
I'm taking one of my little shadow buddies on my shoulder.
You approach Scott and Polly's table to find them crouched behind a pile of jelly desserts, plotting. Thank Bruce if you're here, bro. Come on, join our huddle.
Maybe you're curious about our huge pile of jelly jam gelatinous dessert cups. Well, wonder no more. We're going for the jelly prize.
Yeah, we're gonna win it. If we collect the foil cover of 100 jelly desserts, we will be the lucky winners of...
one free jelly dessert! Ah!
But right now we're stuck. We've only got 99. That means we need...
one more, Scott. We need one more.
We need one more!
You give them your jelly dessert, but you already threw it at a bird person you hate. Guess you gotta make a choice.
Well,
I am bird freaking throws at a bird person from Rick and Morty.
Isn't he dead, though? Didn't he die?
Yes, he died, but he's still a character. I liked him. Okay, steal the final jelly dessert from the jelly dessert factory. Make like a puppy dog and beg. All things are sweeter when achieved through pity. No! Fuck no, they're not.
But isn't stealing wrong?
No, Scott! That's a myth! Like hangovers in the afterlife!
That wet places!
No. Not in the afterlife, and the afterlife.
And the, that's what I said, the. I didn't say in.
No.
Like hangovers and the afterlife. That's what I said.
No, you said in the afterlife.
Okay, well, I apologize.
But if the afterlife isn't real, why are you a ghost?
There's no time for metaphysics, Scott! We've got a heist to plan!
No, Coach says stealing is wrong, unless you are stealing a ball or a base or victory from the jaws of defeat. Actually, it seems like sports is mostly about stealing.
Well, that settles it! Time for stealing!
One fake bus, one real woolly mammoth, and a brutal running gun battle, you finally secure one illicit jelly cup, which you turn in along with your 99 other jelly cups for one free jelly cup.
Whoa.
The shit we went through. Scott is too upset by all the violence, so you split your free jelly cup with Polly. Worth it. All right, brother, where you going? I'm sorry. I mean, ironically, Scott was already at the table with Polly, so you can't visit him now. I didn't mean to do that. But...
wait. I'm gonna go. You know what? Let's see what's up with the cat chick, because she keeps appearing.
On the bottom right?
Yeah. Okay.
Welcome to my little shop. Buy some shit. I have shit that will boost your stats, shit that will lead you into stupid new adventures, even some shit that might be much needed at some very specific moments. So take a look.
We should have been going to her since the beginning.
Why?
Because she sells stuff. We could buy, like, drugs and...
well, let's see. A PR agent. High school social life is so hard nowadays that hiring a PR agent is totally a thing.
I don't have any money.
You have 5 money, and that thing is 5. She's 6, unfortunately, so you couldn't get her. Too poor. It even says right here, too poor for this.
Yeah, yeah.
Oh my god, the tampon used by the... that's something you need for fucking Vera, the blood queen of a former prom queen. Fucking Bob Ross right here. Well, I don't know. I mean, you wasted the turn doing it. You may as well
buy... cocaine?
It is cocaine. You're too poor for it. It's $10. $10 for cocaine. It's a fucking steal. What do you want to buy? You can read the descriptions of shit. Read them out loud if you like.
A fake Latin accent. I'm going to go with the glasses, probably. Wait, I'll borrow them quickly.
Remember when they used to be cool? Now they aren't, but they're so ridiculous that they're still fun in an all twisted way. That game's not wrong. Some impractical yet kind of funny class.
Yeah.
Alright, come on, make a choice,
go with
bro.
Tampon.
You know, for good old blood rituals, or in case you're just a creep with unhealthy obsessions, you're definitely the creep. Oh my god! That killed your stats! Everything but your bonus, luckily, but that shot down everything else to 6!
Well...
ouch, dude!
Well...
I didn't know that fucking happened. Alright, we choose something bad. The fact that Devin bought a tampon... that's bad.
Sonic boom.
So true.
Place orders aside based on how horrible it would be if the selected thing was part of a torture device or legal punishment. Well, actually, I think you take the win on that.
Yeah, yeah.
Buying the tampon is only bad to you. Anybody playing Sonic Boom is horrible. So, yeah.
Spicy McNog.
That's a spicy McNog. Alright, where you going, bro?
Bathroom.
Of course you are. Let's have some serious diarrhea this playthrough. Small bladder! Yes! Dude! Well, that's amazing. You got an achievement for taking the bathroom every time. Oh my god, that's great. Tell yourself in the mirror that you're so bold you would kill a tiny bug-eyed turtle with your bare hands. The monstrous act would instantly give you 500 plus boldness. But come on, you're just talking to yourself in the mirror. What's the merit in that? You know what? You could keep two boldness anyway for saying that out loud to yourself. Jesus Christ, and you're doing nothing with it, too. So it may as well be useless at this point. On a close inspection, you see blood pooling on the floor. And Vera stands over it, smiling broadly, holding the carcass of a skinned goat. Oh, you got the tampon for her thing, right?
Hey, thanks for coming. The fun's just getting started. I know we only need the goat's tongue, but like, if you're going to take the tongue from a goat, might as well take the skin too and make yourself a pair of sweet boots. Yeah. Not that I know how to sew, or would take the time to even if I did, but Miranda has some mer slaves I can borrow. It's a pretty nice tongue, right? Not too fat, not too thin. The right kind of purple.
Ouch.
I think it'll be the most beautiful regal fear... Yeah, Regal, feared prom queen ever to grace spooky high school in no time at all. I fucked that sentence right up, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
It's not a bad plan, except that spiders need to relive themselves too. And it's at that moment that Percival Giant Spider walks in to use the toilet. Uh-oh. Oh, hey, good afternoon, Principal Giant Spider. I'm just holding this skin goat on school property
Because it's for Animal Abuse 3, we're getting a head start on our homework. Because this goat is a spy from a rival institution who was sent here to blow up the school. Which is it, bro?
I'm gonna go with the top one.
Animal abuse. Yeah, because that's a class. That would make sense.
I mean, he's also... Yeah.
What?!
I guess I'm just stupid, too, because I think that would make sense. Why would Animal Abuse 3 not be a monster class? And he frowns at you. You may not want to lie about which classes are offered at the school to the person who sets the schedule. I guess that makes sense. And if you're going to make up a course on animal abuse, you may not want to pitch it to an animal! Oh!
You're an insect.
We're both idiots. Whoops! Did not think of that somehow.
Yeah, no, that's not the reason. They actually meant, there's a really good reason, and it's too late. Principal Giant Spider sends you both to detention for the entire weekend. It's a weekend full of physical and psychological torture, from waterboarding to board meetings about how to instill more empathy in students.
Worst. Well, empathy sucks. You lose +2 fun and smarts.
And I think I am the obvious winner in this game.
I don't really see how your bonus is getting you much anywhere now. Alright, I will go outdoors. That day during recess, you start a half hour raid and it goes full crazy. You spot Juan, the small, magical Latino cat, okay, who seems a bit sad. He explains to you that he's worried that people are so used to calling him Juan, the small, magical Latino cat, that now everyone defines him only by his size, magicality, ethnicity, and species. He's more than that. You correct him. You don't see him in such simplistic terms and convenient definitions. It's just that there are around 23 other different Juans in the school, so adding all that to his name is quite necessary. You tell him you'll never forget about him and the crazy adventures you both lived together in Monster Prom's prequel, Monsters Middle School. You have a great time remembering those crazy stories at a game +2 fun.
Damn. We have the same boldness as
Juan, the magical fun. Latino cat. Oh dear.
Oh my god! Did you hear? They finally invented a tattoo gun that works on ghosts! I'm totally gonna get one as soon as school lets out! Oh shit, we should definitely get matching tattoos, you wanna?
Of course you do. What are you, responsible? The important question is, what kind of tattoo do you wanna get? The entire text of the Necronomicon. You'd be the first half and I'll be the second half, that's cool. Knuckle tats, you get par... Wait. What? You get part ya par, and I'll get tip ya arty. Put our knuckles together, you know what it spells. Knuckles together, how so? Like, I'm just trying to, I mean, I get that however way they line up their hands, it'll spell party, but I'm,
like, which way does that work?
I don't think it does.
No, no. It's gotta be like if I put my fist next to her fist or something.
So like 1, 2, 3, 4.
Yeah,
four.
No. It's gotta be like maybe one on top of each other, like that. Oh, God, I don't fucking know. That's weird. But she likes to party, so sex! That didn't even lead to sex. What? You look blankly at Polly.
What? That's what it spells, right?
Nope, there you go. Party spells up the sex, apparently.
I mean, I could be wrong. Whenever I see a group of letters, I always assume it spells either sex or LSD. And the knuckle tattoo is obviously longer than 3 letters. So sex it is!
Cool. You start to explain that sex is the same length as LSD, but Polly presses a finger to your lips. Oh.
Shh, my little dumpling. If you play your cards right, I'll show you just how long sex can really be.
Dude, I am erect! Okay, she does show you. It turns out it can be as long as you want if you just keep adding X to the end. You gain +2 fun and +1 creativity. Oh, that's fucking awesome. I am the most fun person in the fucking universe. The prom draws near. Who are you gonna take to the prom, Devin?
You know what? It's not working with anyone else, so I'm gonna go with Scott because he's just stupid enough to accept
it. You do have the option of none of them.
Wait, does that mean I can just stay home and watch Netflix?
You're probably gonna go to prom with, like, friends or something. I don't know.
Just go with Scott.
Alright, Scott it is. That could be fun. You sure?
Sure.
Okie dokie. I will take my girl! Oh, please happen. Alright, here we go. This is a moment of truth. Finally pluck up your courage and ask your beloved to go to the monster prom with you. Huh? Prom? I don't know. You're nice and all, but I have a great sense of smell. And somehow this smells like a bad idea. So I should pass, bro. Sorry. You knew you should have taken a shower before asking Scott. What a loser. After that, you
epic loser.
Yeah, after that, you were forced to abandon your home and join the underground society of sad people who couldn't get a date for monster prom. Which is a fancy way of saying you had to live the rest of your life in the fucking sewers. Gross. Alright, let's not have me the same outcome. Okay, please.
Prom? Yes! Yay! It'll be a night to remember! Boo!
Well, it would be a night to...
It would be a night to remember if I wasn't going to get so drunk and high, I most likely won't remember shit the day after. But that's why God invented selfies!
Oh, I don't like her as much in that. Yeah, she's not as, she looks weird. Prom was wild, but still not wild enough for the likes of you. So close to dawn, you decided to keep partying by improvising a dope after party at an abandoned manor house. You partied with a group of classmates for days. Over time, people came and left. Some even died from too much partying.
Jesus.
That's fucking cool. At one point, one of the deities of partying hard appeared, summoned by the deaths of your peers, which turned out to be a sacrifice to him. He declared you his herald and bestowed upon you the supernatural rad party powers like endless confetti, whatever that means. Then he joined you and you all kept partying for another entire week because that's how you roll. Dude, this game is a fucking trip. Oh my god. Most likely to become a lasagna. Congrats,
yeah!
Polly! You be lasagna! Polly's quote, always be loud like love. Oh my god. Fucking crazy. Look at new secret. Okay, I didn't get a secret ending. 19 new events and 19 different outcomes. Whoa! Look, what is it? 1,408 look at the possibilities that this game has! You could literally replay this game a million fucking times over. That's awesome. I guess that's it. Oh, look at that!
I'm in the picture.
Yeah, that guy. That's the guy we were looking at before with the derp face in the background.
Yeah.
That's funny. Those 3 weeks were maybe the most epic and absurd weeks of our lives. After Monster Prom, we kept on living our lives, falling in love, battling for friendship, and learning who we were and who we could be. And you know what? As it always does, life happened. And it was wonderful. Damien became the renowned drug racer until he died in the most badass way during a race.
A renowned drag racer, not renowned drug racer.
My bad. At the funeral, you spotted him hiding among the crowd. He winked at you. That's funny, he faked his death. Scott turned out to be quite a genius and became the most renowned mathematician in the country. JK, he became an athlete, duh. He's still a bit of a simpleton, but as lovable and good-hearted as ever. Polly graduated doing lots of Anahuska, and now she appears to people hallucinating to act as their spirit animal. During those 3 weeks, Monster Prom seemed bigger than life, and then it was gone, just like that. The battle for Monster Prom might have ended then, but there were lots of battles left in that war called youth. But once again, we were young and unafraid and very stupid! And we were ready to start. Aw, that's so cute. Oh, look at that! Wow, that's...
You're gonna get copyrighted.
No, I'm not. This is such a cute thing, though. I love this. There's Slender Man right down there! See him?
Yeah.
That's funny. Oh, Jesse Cox produced this game? That's fucking awesome. Realize that? That's some random knife Damien's got. Freaking gambling. They play as that fire chick.
Wow.
I like all these fan art pictures and
Proof
stuff.
Reader.
Amanda Brown. 15 minutes. Yeah, I'm not gonna. I don't worry about that. Oh, it's hot. Oh, dude, Aaron Hansen is Scott! Aaron from Gang Grumps! Nathan Sharp was there too? Did you saw Nathan? If Nate wants the battle? That's fucking awesome! The Orgy Planner? What? Monster Prom's first cosplayer. Oh my god. Special thanks to all these indie mega booth. Lost Paws! Oh, that's cool! I know him, he's a YouTuber. The Super Beer Bros. Oh my god.
This song is ear raping.
It is kind of weird, yeah, but oh my god, so much heart was put into this game. Game developed by Beautiful Glitch and published by those awesome guys. They are awesome. Oh, hey, what's my girl doing with her head? She ain't giving you head, shut up. Enjoying life. I just sip on my freaking. Alright, you just unlocked an erotic fanfic about dragons. This is about to get weird. Well, that only means. Oh, you have unlocked 10 new images in the gallery. Well, I have to read that erotic fanfic now, obviously. That's the pro. What? I wasn't even the Frankenstein girl! Polly is lesbian?
She does more drugs than you.
Oh, that's hot too. Here. Oh wow, so many. Oh yeah, I'm assuming the credits probably have ending pictures. More art for all. Oh wow, there's a crap ton of this. Oh, all the portraits. Wow, look at all that fan art, please. I wonder if this is real. Is that real? Yeah, these are by real people who did fan art. Oh, that's fucking cool. They get these from actually Twitter? Huh. That's creative and neat.
Another one? No. What are the endings?
I was at the endings. I didn't know. All I got is. Oh! And then that's your ending. That's the one where you fucked up. Why it's her for some reason, I don't know. Why this is the first time I played this game, so we only got the two endings.
Oh my god. All just split personalities.
The
Frankenstein chick has schizophrenia. We're playing as different personalities of hers.
Alright, well, thanks for joining us for Monster Prom. That was a lot of fun. Don't forget to hit that subscribe button, leave a like, a comment of what else you should play in the future.
And definitely come to my channel that isn't dead and stuff.
Yeah, I'll leave a link to your channel, it's fun. But you know what, you gotta start doing shit. I've been telling you that. Alright, we'll see you guys next time. Later! That was ear raping.
Yeah, it was hot too.
No, it wasn't. I don't think it fucking was!